So, they're all going to go in. So, what I do to come out, and I did this when I played, and this is, you know, as a player, you get a routine that you feel works for you, you know, and at the end of my career, this is kind of where I came to, and this is what I teach now. I come in close and start in here, and generally, I'll shoot some one-handed shots. Now, each time I shoot it, I'm getting my middle finger on one of the seams, and I want you to watch kind of the things that I'm doing here. I'm going back very gradually. Okay? Okay, anybody know why I'm shooting one-handed to start with? Anybody take a guess? The reason that one-handed shooting is a very good way to start out a shooting routine or to work on form is because if you get the ball and put it in position with one hand, the fact that the ball is balanced on your hand means that you're in good position. Now, if my thumb is a little bit too far out and my elbow is a little too high, the ball's going to fall off. If my elbow is too far up and the hand's too far back, the ball's going to fall back. And so this is creating good balance. And from here, you know, I know that I'm in pretty good position. So as I'm doing this and I start moving out, I'm going to keep shooting, and eventually here I'm going to add the left hand into the shot. And what I'm thinking here is, I'm thinking middle finger, middle of the ball, middle of the rim. I want to be shooting like this. I do not want to shoot like this. Okay? A lot of players shoot and they follow through to the side. And I'm going to show you why that happens a lot of times and some ways that you can avoid that. All right? As I move out, I'm going to add my left hand here. I'm going to do the same thing. And as you watch my footwork, I'm making a very deliberate move to step forward with my right foot on the shot. And I'm going to explain why in a second. So it's 1-2, middle of the rim. 1-2, middle finger, middle ball, middle rim. 1-2, middle of the rim. 1-2, middle of the rim. Okay, so what's the 1-2? You.
Rhythm,
exactly. What else is it? Why am I stepping forward with the right foot? Anybody?
Align your body.
Align your body, yes. Why else? Come on, somebody's got to have, don't be afraid here.
Preparation,
direction, okay? I think a better word is aggression. It's an aggressive step forward. It's creating inertia, it's creating momentum forward, okay? And as I continue to do this, okay. And keep moving out. As I move out, I'm shooting the ball the same with my hand and everything up here. The only thing that's changing is, as I move out, I lean a little more forward and I make a little more of an aggressive step forward. And so the power for the shot, okay, a lot of it comes from the body angle and the step, okay? Now, I think one of the other fallacies with shooting is that the power for the shot is, hey, I've got to jump higher to shoot it further. And I see kids as they back up and they get back near the three-point line and they jump and then they have to go like this and then they gotta fling that damn thing. And that's hard. You don't have much rhythm there and it's really, really difficult. And so as you move back, it's really important that you not jump as much as you create rhythm. And you do what I call using the floor to create power, okay? Because look, particularly with three-point shooting, if we're spotting up for a three and a guy's running at you, you're not going to shoot it anyway. You're going to show it and probably make a play off one dribble, make a pass. If you have to jump and shoot a three, it better be late game or it better be some kind of end-the-clock situation. Otherwise, it's probably not a good shot. So as I'm moving here, I keep moving slightly back. I'm concentrating on this, and it's the lean first, and it's the step second. People don't know enough about the lean. The lean is really important with shooting. It creates momentum. And as I lean, I create power. As I step, I create momentum. And it allows me the power to get the ball to the basket, like that. Now, a couple other things I think are really important. And you're gonna coach players that do this, players that put the ball back on their fingertips like this. This is, to me, a real no-no with shooting. There are a lot of players who can be very effective at short range shooting like this. Sometimes you see big guys that do it. But as you move back and you get to the free throw line, then you get to the top of the key, if you're putting the ball back like this, you're loading the ball on small, unpredictable muscles that are kind of spring-loaded. And this is why guys become very streaky as they move out, that load the ball on their fingers. And so for power, okay, the power of the shot, it's really important that you get the lean and the step. But I think an even bigger important part is the hand has got to be here instead of here. All right? Now, what do I mean? You want leverage, right? You want leverage to be strong. Now, here I have leverage on the ball. Here the ball has leverage on me. Okay? And so as you catch and shoot, come on over here real quick. What's your name, by the way?
Carl.
Okay, yeah. Carl. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Okay. I'm gonna have you throw me the ball a couple times. As I catch it, I'm getting in this position. I'm getting strong. I'm getting strong here. Get ready to shoot it.
Shoot it or
no, you're throwing the same. I'm the shooter. I'm like this. All right. And look, here's the thing about holding the ball like this crossways. We've got a player, Chandler Parsons, who many of you have seen play. And you know, he got injured last year. And so this summer, he's had to go through a long rehab where he hasn't been able to be on the court that much. And one of the things with his shot that we're working on is he grips it like this. I'm going to talk about the thumb in a second. His thumb is way out here, and he cocks it back like this. And so consequently, the ball being back like this makes his body come like this when he shoots it. And so he's off balance a lot. So I said to him this summer, I said, look, we got some time now. We've got to kind of reinvent how you hold the ball in your shot. You got good feel, you got to do a lot of good things. But I told him, you've got to get here instead of here. And so he's been working all summer on it. And like for the first 2.5 months, he had to shoot shots sitting on an exercise bike because he couldn't do weight bearing stuff. So we were doing this, shooting one-handed shots, sitting on an exercise bike from 6 feet, just over and over and over again. Because the other problem with guys with big hands is, I just see this, players have a tendency when they catch the ball to want to feel it. All right? And as they do this, their thumb comes out like this. And when the thumb goes out like this, this creates big problems with shooting. And here's why. If you got a guy that holds the ball, and this I see this a lot, guys that hold it like this, well, what's the problem here? Elbow's too far out, and really, that ball's going to fall off. All right? So if the thumb is too far out, it's going to bring the elbow to the side. Now, if you're trying to shoot the ball straight, and you've got the elbow out and you've got the thumb in like this, the only way you're going to be able to shoot it straight is you're going to have to somehow do some kind of compensating thing to keep it going straight. And all that's going to lead to a loss of distance and a loss of control. And so the key thing is, with shooting initially, you've got to get the ball, you've got to make your hand what I call as small as possible. I don't want it like this, but I want it like this. I want it natural. I want a natural position on it. Hey, this is not natural. This is, you're trying to crush something. This is natural. So I have kind of a supple feel here, and as I put the ball up, the only place I'm creating any kind of tension is in the back of the wrist, because I want to be firm here. So I want to be strong to strong. Like, if I was going to hit him, am I going to hit him harder like this or like this? Like this, right? So I want to be in a strong position. So here's my wacky world of shooting, all right? I hold the ball like this instead of like this, all right? I'm here instead of here, okay, because this is stronger. All right, and if I keep everything like this, I got a great chance to keep the ball going on a straight line, to keep my direction consistent, which is the hardest thing. And I think that's why you got to start with direction with shooting. Now, the other things that are really important. Okay, throw it to me again. Lean, step, shoot like that, okay? The other fallacy, and this is a real pet peeve of mine, and a lot of you are going to disagree with this, but I'm encouraging you to hear me out, all right, and try this on the floor with your best players, and try it with your worst shooters, okay? The concept is feet square. Feet square. How many believe in feet square when you shoot? Nobody's raising their hand because they know I'm going to kill them. That guy up there, okay, I respect you for raising your hand. For years, I mean, I did the same thing. I came to here and I shot it, and it sounds good. You're square to the basket. You're square. You're facing the basket. The problem with it is that, all right, if I'm square, and I go up to shoot, my body, 100% of the time, my upper body is going to move like this as I release the ball with my right hand. It's just a fact. It's a human fact. And if that's not happening, you're not going to be a very good shooter to start with. But if you watch any great shooter, watch pictures of Larry Bird, you're going to see him like this. Watch Nowitzki, you're going to see him like this. There's an angle, okay? I mean, the upper body has to angle as the strong arm releases the ball. It just has to. And so if we go square, here's what's going to happen. We're going square, we're going up, and we're going to shoot it. Our body is going to end up angling anyway. What we're doing is we're creating a cross torque against ourselves. Okay? And what it's doing is it creates this. And as the upper body turns to get natural and you release the ball, you get this. You get this outwards follow through. So basically what I'm saying is you're stepping forward with the right foot virtually every time if you can. And that's what I believe the best thing is, and I've seen it time and time again. Now, I'm going to have you shoot a couple. Paul's a good example. Paul is a square shooter who has figured out a pretty good way of shooting the ball. Go ahead, shoot it. Okay, now if you see his feet, they're basically square. And I was working with him before we started here, trying to get him to put the right foot forward. And so he was doing this, and he thought he was putting it forward, but he was still square. It's a hard habit to get out of. In order to do it, you almost have to just physically step forward, and you've got to see your foot coming forward. All right, so I want you to shoot a couple, and I want you to just work with me here. All right, and I want you to step forward, lean, step forward, and then shoot. Because the guy's got a really, really nice release, and he's a strong kid. Okay, stay with it. Good. I don't mind misses like that. Those are pro misses. Online, back rim. Good. Good. I want you to back up slightly. As you back up, we're getting more power by being here and here. Okay? Good. Here you go. On the pass. Let's get that right foot a little more forward. Good. Nice job. Back. Same thing. Lean. Step. Good. Back. Lean. Yep. Well, just wherever I tell you to go, don't worry about whether it's a three or a two. Good. Back it up. Okay, now, everybody gets to a point that's kind of their sticking point, okay, where all of a sudden it goes from being an easy shot to a really hard shot. Now, like right here, this is kind of your point. So the key thing here is be firm with the wrist, have a good lean, and make sure you're stepping, and go from here to here. All right? And again, he's doing a pretty good job of starting the ball at his chin. I think that's really, really important. Good. Good. And I don't want you to bring it down here. What happens if he brings it down here? You become vulnerable to the strip, right? If you're in this position here, while it feels like starting low and coming up is creating momentum, it's creating a hitch in the shot, okay? So we want to start here. You know, the last couple of years, one of the things that Dirk has really worked on, and if you guys go to the game today, you'll probably see him doing it in warm-ups, is rebound for me, Carl. He and Holger are working on this. Loading it high and go from there into the shot. Here, up, because this is powerful, and going down to up, you open yourself up for the strip, and you create an extra hitch, and you actually work physics against yourself. All right, now you're gonna stay out there, we're gonna keep doing this. But I think the exercise here is, watch how he's generating power. The way he's generating power when he does it right is with a lack of movement and the correct angles. All right? He's not doing it by doing this or doing this. All right? He's quiet but strong. Good. Good. Now listen, the other thing about this, as you get out there, a lot of people believe you need to shoot a high arc on a shot. I don't believe that. I believe you need to have control of the ball and you need to get it over the front rim. So, as an adjustment here, as you're moving out, you're stepping forward a little more anyway. Lower your trajectory a little bit. You understand what I'm saying? Instead of shooting it way up, shoot it more like that. Good. It's all right. Hey, don't get discouraged, man. Keep going. You're almost shooting at half court. On the floor. Remember, we want the lean and the step. Okay, come in slightly. I think you took too far. Step out. Right there. Good. The number one reason guys that look like they have good form but don't make is because they're gripping the ball too tightly. You can't see it. All right? And coincidentally, these guys also have big hands, so they're wrapping their big hands around the ball and they're squeezing the shit out of it. And so they struggle. And so getting guys to relax and create tension in the proper places, I mean, is a really important thing with shooting. Now, the other thing that's kind of wacky about my approach to shooting. Paul, come on back up. I don't know why you went over there. You guys are all watching saying, okay, he's saying left, right into every shot. That's not very realistic, okay? I'm going to show you a couple of things here. Paul, you're a good example of this. I want you to rebound for me first. I like you, so let's just keep you out of here. So we're going to have you shoot in a second, too. So I'm going to do a little elbow-to-elbow drill, okay? And I want you to watch how I do it and compare it to how you would teach your guys or girls, all right? And we'll talk about it in a second, okay? Wait, don't throw it yet. This way again. Okay. What do you notice? Yes. I put the ball down. Okay. That's a sin. It's a cardinal sin. I what do they call it?
Always left, right.
Yes. I'm always going left, right. Now, can I always go left, right? No. Okay? This was a situation that I consider a spot-up type situation. Paul, pass to me out here. If you've got a situation like this, where it's a pin down, you gotta go right-left. All right? You gotta go right-left. And so, when you go right-left, how do you create the same rhythm? How do you create the same 1-2 rhythm? Well, what you gotta do is you gotta kind of create that same cadence. And instead of being able to step forward with your right foot for leverage and momentum, what I'm doing is I'm controlling this with my upper body. So I'm getting a 1-2, and as I go up, I get my upper body kind of leaning in like that. And so this is one of the adjustments we got to make. I'm coming like this, keeping the ball high, 1-2, and then up. And so, no, you can't go left-right all the time. Whenever possible, I'm getting to a left-right. And the guy that made me believe in this was Rick Pitino back in 1988. Because the next season, we shot more threes than any NBA team in history had ever shot. So, Paul, I'm going to have you do this drill now. I'm going to have you go left, right on elbow to elbow. Okay? Yeah, go left as well. Yeah. Can you do that? Good. All right, after you shoot it, you're going back. And one of the things about this is that we gotta consciously put ourselves back further than normal. You know, we want to be on the move. It's like all this clapping shit and standing up and sitting down. It's, you know, we want to be on the move. If we're on the move, if a player is on the move, the chance of him overthinking and thinking about the miss instead of concentrating on the process diminishes by a zillion percent. So we want to keep guys moving around. All right, so I want to see you moving around. Are you enthusiastic today?
Of course.
Hell yeah, I'm enthusiastic. Come on.
Yep.
You want to give me a hell yeah? Hell yeah, okay, there he is. All right. I'll pass it, you help me rebound. He's not going to miss anyway. Ready? Good. Good. Keep moving. As soon as you shoot it, get yourself back. Get back. Good. Keep going. Good. Now back it up a little bit. Back it up 6 inches. You got to back it up for We're shooting it right from there. Good. 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 See, he's actually stepping in better with his right leg. Stay with it. Good. Now I want you to shoot a little further out now. I want you to shoot him here and then over there. So even back further. Go ahead. Nice, good. Good. Nice, good. Good. Okay, stop for 1 second. The other thing that's really important about this, if I'm the shooter, is I don't step until that guy's ready to pass me the ball. Like, in other words, I don't want to be stepping and wait and having to wait, okay? I want to make sure he's ready to throw it, so as I step, I'm getting real momentum in the shot. Because if I have to wait a second. If I have to wait, now he throws, I don't have the same momentum. And so, do you understand what I'm saying? Delay until he's ready to throw it, and then when he's ready to throw it, then you're stepping in, all right? Now we're shooting threes, back and forth. Good. 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 Now hold on a second. Going this way, if you're noticing his footwork, when he goes to his right, he's pretty good stepping forward. When you go to your left, you go like this. Like that. And so one of the reasons is I think maybe you're not back far enough. All right, so get yourself back a little bit further. And as soon as you shoot this shot, I want you to get over there as quickly as possible, ready to step straight in to this shot. You're kind of hovering in the middle. Shoot there, get here. Shoot here, get there. Okay? Nice job, good. Nice, good. Good. Get that thing, Carl. Nice job, good. Good. Well, let's make two in a row. Nice. Good job. Give me a hand. Give me a hand. Give me a hand. Give me a hand. Okay, so look, I will bet anything, okay, that most of you, a lot of you, maybe not most of you, would have said, hey, when you're going this direction, you gotta pivot like this. And look, I used to believe it too. But here's what I encourage. All right? This is what I encourage everybody to do. Be open-minded, okay? I know that this is better. I know that it's better. Now, if we're running a play here and, you know, Paul runs a flare screen and Carl sets a flare screen and he has to shoot a three real short order right here, you know, he may have to shoot right left. You know, he may have to. And if he does, I'm an idiot for running that play. It's a hard play. And it doesn't give him the best possible chance. I'm going to run stuff that allows him to flare wide. Go ahead. You're going to flare wide, and you're going to go left, right, into the shot. Here you go. Again, come on. Ready? Clear? Good? Yeah. Well, hell, go ahead and shoot it. Yeah. All right, ready? Clear? Good. Good. Now, you're like this. Probably because you're worried about the line, and you were worried about the line because you weren't back far enough. So what you got to do is on your flare, you got to get up wider like this. That way, you can do that. Let's do it one more time. There you go. Much better. Good. Again. Again. Good. Nice job. Nice job. Good hand. Good hand. Good hand. The first thing we're doing, whether you hold it like this or you hold it like that, we got to have the thumb in a natural position, and we're not going to be out like this. If we're out like this, we're going to be doing this, all right? And we're going to have to compensate. If we're like this, natural, we're going to be in a great position to shoot that thing straight and follow through straight. We want a middle finger, middle rim follow through. We want the hand to be going here and not to be going here. All right, that's the first thing. Second thing, footwork, all right? There's two things, it's the body, it's the lean, and then the step. If I'm right-handed, I'm leaning and I'm stepping, all right? Third thing, position of the ball. We want it here, all right? Paul, throw it to me. We want it here. We want to go from here to here. We don't want to go like this. We don't want to go like this, okay? So this puts us in a quiet position, in a strong position. This gets us strong, this gets us strong, this gets us strong. Those are the key things. And look, once you get the direction down, you know, the distance is pretty simple. It's just the rhythm, and you've got to adjust to your body dynamics and mechanics and the way you hold the ball and stuff. And that part of it you can get. Now, Carl, let's go. What we got to do is get you shooting ball with one hand. Okay, you're right-handed, correct?
Yeah.
And look, you're strong enough now. So come on in here. Now I want you to do this, and I'm gonna have you. I didn't have Paul grip it my stupid way because he does a pretty good job shooting it the way he does. I'm gonna have you grip it my way because you need to be liberated here. Okay? So look, we're holding it like this. All right? And I want you to shoot some one-handed shots in your close. All right? And I want you to relax. We're all as full of shit as anybody, okay? Don't worry about missing or anything like that. Good. Oh, that's great. Here, I want this thumb to be here, natural, and not out there. Good. Good. That's three swishes in a row. There's four switches. You're holding the hand behind the back like you're in a handcuffed or something. Just, you can just go like this. So you're not in prison here, although it may seem that way. Good. Again, we're just doing this footwork-wise. What's he got to start doing here a little bit? Got to start stepping into it. So what I'm going to have you do here in a sec is every time you get it, here, step, and then shoot. Okay? Because like if I hadn't stepped there, that one wouldn't have gone in. Step, and then shoot. Good. Now let's just take your time. Take your time. Now I want you to go like this, here, and then step, and then shoot. Thumb in. Good. That's all right. Take your time. Very good. Good. Now go back like 2 inches this time. Same thing. Very good. Very good. Same shot. Good. Now that time you didn't really step. I want to see, make sure you get that left right every time. Now we're going to start adding the left hand on here. Okay? All the left hand is doing is helping you get the ball to here so that you can shoot it with one hand. Okay? Go slow. Okay, it's hard because you're used to doing it and you're still doing it. So I want you to just, and look, we want to shoot the ball here. If we're gonna shoot it back here, this is the one I talked about. The balance thing is not gonna pass the smell test. You got to shoot it from here. So now you shoot from here and not like this. You just swished eight in a row shooting that way, right? Come in just a little bit. Very good. Good. Again. Good. Good. Now, one thing that you're doing, if you watch him, he's got this. He's loading it back on his fingers. All right. What we need you to do is to be here and shoot it. Okay? Instead of here. I mean, this is hard. That's hard. And in order to shoot that way, you're going to have to use two hands. We don't want to do that. So you understand what I'm saying? You should be firm with the wrist. Good. Good. Okay. We got to get a little lean, and then the step. Okay. That's much better. Good. Back it up a little bit. Much better. Good. Good. I want you to grip it like this every time. Middle finger, middle ball, middle of the rim. Perfect. Good. Good. Keep going back. Good. Nice and firm with the wrist. Okay, that one you got the fingers wide and the thing got back like this. See, Carl, right?
Yeah.
All right, Carl, here's the thing that Carl's got to do. Instead of getting like this, you got to get like this. This instead of this. This is a difference of about 8 feet of range. Because when it goes back like this, then you're going to be really struggling to get it there. Okay? Shoot a few more. Good. Be aggressive though. Got to get the lean and the step. There you go. Nice job. Good. Be aggressive. Be aggressive. Lean, step. Finish the shot. Swish. Good. Back it up a little bit. Swish. Good job. Give me a hand. Give me a hand. Understand? Understand? Understand what I'm saying? Yeah. So look. It's two different guys, and these guys got different body mechanics, right? I mean, Paul is lower to the ground. He's got shorter arms. He's built stronger. So his set of physical tools are going to be different than Carl's. I mean, it's just as simple as that. And I think one of the other fallacies with shooting is that, hey, there's just one way to shoot, and this is the right way. I've seen guys who are great, 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 great shooters that happen to have a set of body parts that just sit perfect behind the ball. And I know they have busted their ass to be great shooters and all that, but their hands are much smaller than the guy they're trying to teach. And the guy with the big hands and the long fingers is one of the most challenging things in coaching, because those guys tend to want to grip the ball, they tend to want to feel the ball, and as their hand gets bigger on the ball, it gets more difficult to shoot it because they bring tension and they spread the thumb, which we've talked about. And so these are all things that are going to be, I think, things for you to look for, because you're going to come across all different kinds of players with all different kinds of shots. And there's sometimes you're going to come across a guy with a really unorthodox shot that goes in a hell of a lot. And I'm telling you right now, leave that guy alone. Let him do it. I mean, because every once in a while, there's going to be a guy like that. Not very often, but every once in a while. Does anybody have questions about any of the stuff that I've talked about? Yes?
Everything about tests that you what about after 2 or 3
dribbles? I'm going to do that stuff tomorrow. Yeah, I'm going to go through that tomorrow, but it's a good question. And, you know, generally, I think what I would say is this. You know, we still want to have the same concepts working for us. You know, if I'm dribbling, you know, I still want to go left-right when I can do it.
Also, when you go left.
Well, it depends. It depends. Now, Carl, set a ball screen. Set a low ball screen, okay? If I'm coming down here, I'm coming like this, I got to go right left on that one, right? It's tight, and you don't have the time to flip it around. But if I'm running a drag screen in transition like this, and my guy is going to go under both players, you know, go ahead, come on. I'm coming here, and I'm loading it up left-right because I'm far out. I've got the time because the guy went under, and I'm going to put myself in the strongest position possible. And so I'll talk more about that stuff tomorrow, and we'll do some more demonstrating. And look, this stuff is different. I walked in the door telling you that, you know, you're all going to be rolling your eyes at some of this stuff. But, you know, here's the reality. The game continues to change. There's more pace, and there's more skill. And there's going to be more three-point shooting before there's less three-point shooting. And right now, one of the things that we do in Dallas is, you know, we do a lot of drills where our guys shoot the ball 2 or 3 feet behind the NBA line. Because, not only because it's great practice to get the range, but also shooting further out is going to have to become a fact of life at some point. It is now. I mean, there's guys now that shoot the ball from 30 feet. Look at Steph Curry. I mean, that guy is ridiculous. And he was shooting step back shots from the hash mark in the finals, you know. Thompson for Golden State. I mean, these guys can shoot from anywhere. And if you watch those two guys, you watch Thompson in particular, it's here and there. It's here and there. It's very still, and then he lets it go. There's not a lot of movement in that shot. Curry's the same thing. He's here and there. These guys both load it high, and they let it go, and they create a lot of power, not only because they have a lot of bounce and strength in their legs, they're in great leverage positions where they have the ball and they keep it simple.